Hello everybody and welcome back to the Dark Souls playthrough. We are at Farn Keep, one of my favorite places in the game. This is actually really, really well done. The only thing I hate about it is just the goat people who hop on your face and just... Well, the one goat and the one goat enemy in this area that just hops on your face and consistently will rape, not rape, but it's more or less like they just kind of go to town on your face. And it's really, really annoying. It's hard to deal with, but it's fine, I guess. It's not fine at all. It's actually really annoying. I wish they would do something about it, but there's not much you can really do about it, considering the fact that all it really is just him hopping on your face, and he gets like a massive buff, like off of just him hopping on your face. But other than that, the area is fine. I love the scenery and all the crabs over there. I was joking about the crabs. The crabs hurt quite a bit. Oh, Greyrat's still down there. Let me see what he has. Let me see what he has here. So, did I or did I not already get the? I did. So I've already got Solaire set in this playthrough. I was just double checking because it's like I'm doing like another playthrough as well. That's why, not for Dark Souls, but well, I'm doing an assassin playthrough because I want to cheese people, so that's the reason why basically. I don't know if I'll post that. I might. I'll post the invades with that build when I'm finished with it, but this is just like a straight playthrough of like the story mode and things of that nature, and I just want to keep it as such with that. Also, the Butcher's Blade is a very amazing weapon. I love it. It's just so good. So, if only I had Lightning Spear though. I mean, I'm close to the area where you get Lightning Spear too, so I'm not far from that area. Nice, it finally got upgraded. Decently, even though it doesn't do a crap ton now, it still does a decent amount. So I saved the Pyromancer and I saved the Mage, and I also saved the Priestess Lady. So. Now we're going to travel back to... It was this one. I always get them confused. Not Farn Keep, but the Keep Ruins. Keep Ruins is halfway into the swamp of Farn Keep, which leads up to the Door of Wolf's Blood, which is what we're going to base them up today. I'm not going to really Ember yet. I'm not going that way. I mean, because... Oh wow, interesting phantom. Wearing like the heaviest set ever, but as you can see, I've already lit like two of the flames. I just have to figure out which way I'm gonna go to. Go to the other bonfire? Not over there, but trying to remember where this bonfire is. I believe it's this way. But I know there's like an undead bone shard in here where all these poison slugs are. Oh crap, that's not funny. At least they can't hit you through the walls though, Jesus Christ. I definitely should have buffed my weapon before I walked in here. But they still hurt a lot though, oh my god. I was expecting that exact damage, but still. There's the thing. That's all I was looking for. And there's also a type of shield that's over there that I do want to go grab before I continue. Also, one of the things I really do not condone about Farn Keep for a lot of reasons is if you're going to go for the Black Boil Forest, yes, go for it. Only thing that I recommend that you don't do about it, don't do when it comes to going for said item of like the Black Boil Forest, is, well, there are these things here that I don't know what they're called. And there's also like an Estus Soup here, which there's only a few of these in the game, apparently, from what I've noticed. There's not that many. They're just there, I'm guessing, just in case you die. And they refill, apparently. They refill, from what I've noticed. But back to what I was just saying about the weird creatures in the swamp here. They're like these evolved goat creatures that are a lot bigger than the normal goat creatures. Like, they're giant goats, I think. I don't know if I said that right, but they're like goats with tree branches, and they're covered in feathers, and they're like huge. They're about as tall as a tree, and there's three of them guarding the Black Bone Forest, which is a really good weapon. Only drawback about it is if you're running a dex build, it's gonna hurt trying to even get to them because they can damn near one-shot you. If you're running a strength build like I am, you might be fine, I guess. I'm not even gonna try that because I'd probably fuck up in some way or another, and I'm scared to. Only reason I'm scared to is because they hop on you at one time, and it's kind of annoying. Like, from what I've noticed and what I've kind of learned about it, is you could use a bow and you could hit them from a distance. So it would be easier that way. Oh, and there's also a dog in the background. This is the Covenant for the Watchdogs of Farn. And you basically you're able to join the Covenant. You can ask to join the Covenant, and when you ask to join, you don't exactly join immediately. You get this emblem here, which you can equip in your emblem slot. As for proof of the Covenant, I can offer a Wolf's Blood Sword Glass, which I don't mind. I'll gladly offer that. My hands look like crab hands, oh lord. Covenant allegiance deepened. Then now I'm going to Ember because I want to go and fight what's at the very top of this place. Hoping that someone's here, but I don't know. I'm honestly scared to fight this thing by myself. Granted, there are embers up there. Like, granted, there's a crap ton of embers up there, so that's not the problem. I can get to the ember. That's not the issue. The only issue I have is just this big creature that's just chilling up there. And it's just really scary. You'll see what I mean in like a few seconds here when I go up here and fight it. Because I'm gonna have to switch my ring too. Because reasons, and it's a hassle even fighting it. It's super, super annoying. So I'll just switch that. I mean, the blue tiercer ring really isn't even that good though, that's the thing. And plus I'm just sporting the Brigand set because I wanna be able to not fat roll, so. Yeah, and just even putting on Solaire's helmet makes you fat roll too, which is impressive. If I wear that would make me fat roll. So I had to kind of stick with the Brigand set. Because what I've learned in this game is it does not matter how high your defense is unless you're wearing the Havel set. This is the only stipulation to this rule. It does not matter how high your defenses are. You're still gonna get probably damn near one-shot by a lot of the stuff in this game because of the fact that you just don't have the defenses that are required for a lot of reasons. Because this game kind of does hurt, and I don't mind really wearing this, truth be told, because it would be easier. But I'm trying to cover up my hideous bacon face. That's why my face is like hella bacony because I had gone to what's his name. I had gone to the person who makes you, or to the creature in the game who basically makes you, who hollows you to let you have levels. And that actually works fine. I'm fine with the Cocktail's Mask with this set, because Fashion Souls matters, I guess, but still, I mean. I'm trying to figure out which will not make me fat roll the hardest. That's the only reason why it's such a hard decision. Because it's between Lucatiel's Mask and the Chain Vest, and then the hat, but Lucatiel's Mask is only adding up to +4. So it's not making fat roll super hard, but it's not making me fat roll immensely either, so. So I'm gonna go up and fight this scary ass demon that's sitting up here at the top of the shrine. And there's only one of this demon in the game too, so a type of demon like this, because not a normal demon as you might notice. It actually lost its flame apparently, from what I've been told. Because I like to study the things like this as well with Dark Souls, because I like to. Oh my god! And my shield was not equipped. Jesus Christ. Well, I grabbed the embers, that's the upside, but I'm not gonna use it this time because there's no reason to. There's nobody around the bonfire, I'm not even gonna bother, so. I have enough health and I should be fine, so. It's just I had to equip my shield. Do I have like a different shield that I could use, like in this situation? Well, stats wise, because the Twin Dragon Great Shield. I mean, this lets me use my weapon skill, so it's like, that's why I prefer this over the other one. But it doesn't let me guard as much as I would, as if I was using like this one. Because at least with this, I can guard a decent amount and not like die almost instantly. When you roll right into the attack. Truth be told, I've never soloed this demon before either. That's why I'm not embering, because it's just like, I'd prefer to just solo it because I kind of know how to kill it, but I think its weakness is fire actually. What other weapons do I have? I'm just trying to think off the top of my head, like, what do I have that I'm reinforcing or whatever. I mean, Black Firebomb sounds like a good idea. I would think, but. Because it would make it explode, so, I don't know. It looks like a bunch of rocks, actually. Which is weird, it just looks like a malamication of rocks. I think I said that really well. A malamication of rocks. Of some kind of that nature. I like this mask though, it's really nice. The only thing that's weird about it is that it looks like the eyes are covered, but I don't know why. Not like covered as in like, obviously it's a mask and it's covering the eyes, but I'm talking about it looks like it has eyelashes. Like really, really heavy set eyelashes. Okay, let's go up here. It's a monster, it's a fucking demon, what are you talking about? Also, what I've learned too is that you can get out of its grasp when it does grab you by mashing the ever loving shit out of L2 or L2 RG, whatever remote you're using, just mash the hell out of the bumpers. From what I've noticed, because I didn't know you could do that until like literally the first time I fought it solo, I didn't know you could do that because I was sitting there just getting crushed by it. But you literally can just mash the bumpers and pray that. That you just mash them and he'll let go of you. Because you're basically struggling to get out of his grasp, and yeah. I think I'll just switch the shield, I'd say like that would be the better option. At least this way with the kite shield, I could still use my weapon ability and I'd still block, so. That's why I want the Shield of Want, because the Shield of Want lets you, the Shield of Want lets you get extra souls, and you can also use your weapon skill. Oh, nice, a great axe. What the hell? You can break his legs, I didn't know that. Oh god. That's really scary, I never knew that. Whoa. I'm really confused here. I don't know what to do. I don't, because I can't get near him. It's like, because he's legit screaming in pain, and I feel so bad for him. Because I broke his legs. He's like, help me. Please. Can I just throw, like, a bomb at him? Or? Yeah, I guess that's what I'm about to do. I feel hella bad for him. Like, he's trying to get to me. He can't. Like, I can hear him screaming in agony, and I feel actually really bad for, like, what is the word? Not, like, treating him like this, but it's like, I kinda have to kill him, so. And I can't even switch into my menu quick enough that I don't trust myself to do that. Oh, I killed him, but I didn't know you could break his legs, I just never knew that. Yeah, note to self, never knew that, but you could break his legs. Because it shocked me that he just crippled to the ground and he just lost his legs. I was like, wow, I just didn't know what to say. I was just at a loss for words. Because I was like, I didn't know they would go into that much depth just to make it so you could, they could make it so you could understand that you can break his legs and then be able to do that much damage to him.
I guess they did that for, well, no, because he has an anti-archer thing too, where he will more or less like hit archers harder, in the sense that like he'll more or less go after archers. Like in the sense that if it was an archer fighting him instead, the archer would have a harder time fighting him because of the range difference, and that's it. That is a beautiful view. Oh my god, look at that. You can see all of Farron Keep from up here. And if I fell, that'd be one hell of a fall. So what you get over here is you actually get two really, really amazing items. You first need to this bug, if I can get to it. I only got one of them. That's upsetting because I'd have to respawn it into the area. But you get a lightning spear by the dragon's head, and you also get the dragon crest shield, which I'm actually gonna equip because it's got better stats than the kite shield. And well, you can parry with this, but yeah. And the lightning spear, I'm gonna attune to my fancy when I get a chance. I'm done with this bug, because this bug just made me wake up like this legion of undead nonsense. And bug, please, not like this. That's why I hate spears. You just can't parry a spear really in this game. It's so fucking impossible. You can guard break a shield, but that's about it. Exactly, but all you can do is just guard break a shield, but you can't parry a shield. You can't parry a spear, but you can guard break someone who's spamming your shield when it comes to that. And oh, I could technically fall down there and somewhat survive, I don't think, but I highly doubt I'd survive. At the health that, at the vigor that I have right now, I highly doubt I would survive. Oh god. OMG. I didn't know there was two of them up there. No, I'm being completely honest. I had no idea. I completely was abysmally unaware that there were two of them up there. Why is there one just sitting here? And he's dead. Questions with no answers. One shield, I already got a few of those. And that pretty much clears the area, give or take, because I believe the bugs respawn. That's happened to me a few occasions where I didn't kill them and they do respawn. So, oh, and how you actually do get back is yes, you do go up here and you do fall. Because I just realized that because there's no way to actually get back. You either would homeward bone back or you would fall down. Because those are really the only two ways that you can get back. Which is kind of risky, only because of the fact of, well, this reason right here. I mean, sure, I could roll down or just fall down. Oh, okay, never mind, it's not that bad. I thought I was gonna be worse off. But I like how you can just see the view of Lothric Castle just in the distance right there. It's really nice, I like it. And then Farron Keep below. So Soul of the Stray Demon, this will get you either the Havel's Ring, which I desperately need, or what is it? The pyromancy spell, which is basically a boulder that comes out of your mouth if you have a pyromancy flame. And it's, in my personal opinion, I don't like it because it's good when it comes to clearing a small room. But truth, like, just to be honest, it's not that good, in my opinion. It just isn't good. It wasn't as good as I thought it was at first. I thought it was faster, and I thought it would be longer range, but it's the weight of the boulder of what you have to throw out of your mouth is what's the thing that threw you back. Because when you do throw the boulder, it's like... When you do throw the boulder, it's basically like you throw it, but you have a delayed moment of a stance where you're preparing the boulder, and then you actually toss said boulder. And it's just really interesting because it doesn't make sense to me on why they did it that way. But also, once you get the Dream Chaser's Ashes out of that place, you can also give them to the Shrine Handmaiden and she will prepare new items for you. You can tell her where you found it or not. I always tell her because I don't mind. I never chose the other option, I just didn't care enough to choose. And she basically will give you access to a few new items. Like leather gloves and things of that nature in the exile set. And actually lightning pine resin. Which will be great with this build, and she also gives you an infinite supply of Titanite shards. So that's always helpful. Now I have to go up here and go and give this Soul of a Stray Demon to one of the Lords of Cinder. I'm surprised he wasn't a boss. I feel like he's going to be a DLC boss, Ludeth. Oh, he's in the Ultimate Universe, like Alternate Universe Ludeth or something, I don't know. I think that'd be pretty cool. I would enjoy that. Now let's equip this Haveling, because God knows I need it. Also, burn Undead Bone Shard, increasing our bonfire to 2. Well, it's bonfire level 3, but the SS Flash should be at 2, which is weird. I don't know what that is, because you're already at bonfire level 1, so. And now, we equip the Sunbro set, and I hope that it won't be too overbearing. It's gonna already be overbearing, I can already see it. Even with the Havel's Ring, it's gonna be making me fat roll. Oh, it doesn't! Yes! I'm happy. No, I love this set, that's why. I really, really love this set. It's like my favorite set in the game. Or one of my favorite sets in just all the Dark Souls. This is not a cosplay, I'm just wearing the set because I love it. And it actually... It kind of helps in some situations. How many embers do I have? I have 2 embers. And I do have a refine, so I can actually level this for refine and actually make it scale harder. Well, not scale harder, but yeah. Oh, I can infuse it. Wow, that's upsetting. Wow, sad face. I would need Titanite shards, which I'm tempted to actually, because I have like what, how many, I have one large Titanite shard, so I would need like a decent amount more to, no, because I want to level to like level 5, but yeah. And now let's just continue and just go to this, but back to this bonfire, and then basically continue on and go to the Abyss Watchers fight, which is another one of my favorite fights. The Abyss Watchers is very, very fun. In the sense that they all... There's three of them. Hence the name Abyss Watchers, but... Oh, I also forgot to do this. Well... I don't know. I kinda want to, but... It's between me wanting to Ember and not wanting to Ember, but... I think I should be fine, so... The fact that these slugs are just sitting at the bottom of the well bothers me. They're just there. It's like, that's just really, really annoying. I believe we go this way, actually. Because I'm trying to remember this off the top of my head, and I think it is this way. It is, because you have to go through, like, two of these bird things. And if you hug the wall, actually, they won't notice you. From what I've done before, because they really, truly will not notice you. And if they do, you can choose to fight them. Which... Which is always a possibility, but it's like... just be forewarned, they do hurt quite a bit. You can try your luck, like I'm about to right now, and sneak over here, grab those Titanite shards, and then just walk back over here and pray that they can see you. Cause I'm just gonna hug the wall and keep walking. Cause if he doesn't see me, oh god. Okay, I got so scared, you have no idea, guys. I actually was gonna shit myself, like, oh, please. No, no, no. Once you get past the first one, the second one is really the only issue because that one kind of notices you almost immediately. He didn't notice me, okay, thank God. I actually was gonna cry if he noticed me. I'm so serious, cause I'm like, please. It's because of the fact that when they attack, they hit the ground with their staff, or their tree branch in this case, and they literally awaken all souls in that little general vicinity, yes, from the tree branch. There are these little red skulls, and they come out of the tree branch, and they hit you, and they make you stagger and mess up your poise, which in turn will open for an attack for the creature to just smash into the ground. Which is why I don't really prefer it. The only way I would prefer it is if you were running like a Havel build and you had like vitality for years and strength for years, and you were running a Havel build, like I said, with like the Dragon Slayer Great Axe, you would actually be fine, because it wouldn't be an issue to you because you're Havel, so you're just tanky as hell, so there's no reason why it would be an issue. Quite something ahead. Okay. So now, I'm not gonna go back down that way. I'm actually gonna homeward bone to the last one that I rested at, which was that bonfire, just to avoid any complication with these things. And now I might actually use the Ember, but at the same time I don't know if I want to, because around that area you actually fight Longfinger Kirk, which is ironic, because I didn't trigger him in that area, only simply because I just didn't want to deal with it personally. And these slimes are just really, really annoying, I'm not gonna lie to you. They just do a lot to me because of the set that I'm wearing, and it's like it legitimately has no resistances when it comes to poison. So My intelligence really isn't that high, so. Well, my faith has to be pretty high for the bolts to actually do a decent amount. You gotta make sure you kill their mother before they. Oh my god, those things are terrifying. Look at these things. Look at its face. I can't get over that. They're just like. They took their time on these things. Like, Jesus Christ. Just go to sleep. Go to sleep. Go to sleep. Go to sleep. Don't wake up your brothers and sisters, just go to sleep. This weapon doesn't do the specific amount of damage I was expecting, Jesus Christ. And the fact that they skirmish so well, they just start swiping, like they've never held a weapon. It's so annoying. Like right now, because I run out of stamina right when I start fighting him. It's like so annoying. It's like, oh, I hit it 3 times with my combo. And then it's just like swing, 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 just swing city. Like it just continues to swing. Oh, and there is a dark spirit up here. Well, actually, there isn't a dark spirit, but what you can do up here is you could actually let those things fight it out. Because there's 2 dark rays right ahead. And you can let them fight it out with all of those goat creatures that are actually defending the, basically defending the swamp, give or take, or defending the Abyss Watcher's gate. And I'm gonna go around. I'm not gonna interfere with any of this. I'm gonna let them fight. Cause you still get souls for it, so. The only time I'm gonna intervene is at the very, and when they go and fight the other two. And he sees me, holy shit. When that greatsword is the best greatsword in the freaking game. I mean, not greatsword, but it's like a. Holy moly, that's a lot of damage. Cool, so I got that, and I got the dark. This is the problem with me and getting this damn sword. I always get this sword on the first try. It does not make any sense. Like, I shit you not, on literally 2 other playthroughs of this game, I just have swords sitting in my inventory. Why? Because I just keep getting the sword for free damage. It's like not even funny. I don't know if he killed them though. That's my only concern. I don't know if he didn't fight them up, or he didn't make it to them, I don't think. Oh, as you can hear in the distance, you can hear the Abyss Watchers actually fighting inside. They're actually sparring and killing each other, waiting for their next challenger to show up, which was technically you, the Unkindled, basically. And as you can see, all the swords just sitting in the arena. And you can summon someone here. Crack the Night Orb. Just making sure that I didn't miss anything. Alright, and. Well, because the dark sword I'm actually gonna equip, because I'm gonna boost it to its max level and yada 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 and all that nonsense, because it's really really good. So. Just want to make sure and see if there's any summon signs here before I begin this fight. Oh, there's a summon sign all the way over there, though. Don't know why. Like, they're all over here for some reason. Which is odd, because they're normally at, like, the very beginning of the door. Strange. Yet there's no summon sign over there, but there's just barely any, which is weird. That's a bit much for just sparring, don't you think? He looks like something from Bloodborne. And just look at that stance, he's just like, "Are you my next challenger?" Just pointing his blade at you, just doused in his comrade's blood. And this, the one thing I loved about this fight was the fact that it basically felt like you were fighting an invader. Like the way that they had set the fight up. Because basically, there's more than one Abyss Watcher that does show up, there's actually three that show up. At the most, and I don't know about it being a difference on moving plus, but I know three do shit. And they are actually relentless, and they all wield the same thing. Cool, we got him. Well, first stage. First stage, all three of them show up and they actually fight each other, or you can fight them immediately. And then this happens, where actually all four Lords of Cinder, technically five counting the last boss, all have a second stage. And their second stage involves them being imbued with, they basically become Embered. And their Embered is different than your Embered. Your Embered is you just get health and get flamed. Their Embered is they just become a lot more agile and very, very powerful, and deal fire damage out the wazoo. Thank you. These backstabs are on point though, oh my god. I'm just like... And we did it! Well, yeah, basically. He mostly did all the work, cause... yeah. I was just throwing in jabs for a lot of other reasons, but... yes. And now, we finally get to this bonfire that leads to the Catacombs of Karthus, which is an annoying, annoying area for a lot of reasons. As far as I know, it's filled with skeletons and a very surprisingly easy boss, from what I understand. But the area in itself is very intricate and it's like a labyrinth, and I enjoy playing through it. But... I guess that's just where I'm gonna cut the video short. If anything, see you later guys, it was fun.